So you're looking to understand the power of Todoist. Well, you've found the perfect place. This will guide you through Todoist and how to use it and really understanding the majority of features. We're going to explore everything from managing your today area to your calendar and everything in between. So welcome and let's dive in. So this is Todoist, and I think the best place to start is the today area. Now the today area can be configured in a wide variety of ways. And one of the things that you can get started doing is adding your first task. Now inside of Todoist, everything you add is, a little bit like natural language, which is helpful, but can sometimes be a little bit difficult to learn at that initial stage. So for example, if I wanted to write an article, I could type that in, but if I was wanting to do it tomorrow at 2 p.m., then that is what's called a due date. Now, a due date can be something typically when you start a task, and a lot of people find that to be a helpful indicator. Now, you could write Todd at 1 p.m., you could write next week at 2 p.m., or you could even write something like every day at 3 p.m. if it's a habitual task that you want to do. Now, if said article needs to be completed because it's a work-based one, at say Friday at, 3 p.m., let's just say Friday this week, then what's going to come up is this indicator. This is what's called a deadline in Todoist and will indicate when you need to get it done by. So the due date is potentially when you're going to do it or focus on it or start it, and the deadline is when you're going to need to complete it as a level of importance. Now, if you type in hashtag, now this is all of the things, all of the different projects that you have. And we'll show you how to create a project, do not worry. But in this case, I'm going to set this as a priority inside of this workspace. You can access by using the hashtag, just typing in whatever workspace you want and whatever project that's part of that. So there's three indicators of priority, P1, P2, P3. And P1 is most important, P3 is least important. There's also a P4, and this is already a P4 because it has no priority level. So there's no need to even do anything if you don't want to add a priority level, that's totally fine. But if you want to add P2 because it's a medium level task, then you can. So there is an indicator of a reminder. You can turn this off if you do want. So removing the reminder means that you won't get a notification. Notifications can be set up on your desktop or your mobile device. So there are a few other additional things like labels, if you're a premium member, location as well, and there are other extensions and abilities which we'll dive into. If you have other people that you're working with, you can assign it to somebody else. In this case, that's just using the plus indicator, which is a helpful way to add a task. Now down here, you can give the description a little bit of flavor. So this one, an article about what apps parents should use. And I'm going to go ahead and press add task. Now, obviously that disappears because it's not assigned to today. So I'm going to go to the priorities area and find it here. Now, each of the tasks has this, an area where you can add subtasks, which are broken down items inside of a task. Your assignee, your due date, your deadline date, your labels, your reminders, your location. Why is location important? You can add something to be a reminder-based location, which is helpful. For example, if you arrive home, it could be clean the car. It could be clean the house. But everything or any time you locate yourself in a certain area using the mobile app, that's what's going to pop up, which is a helpful premium ability. Now, from here, you can also do a few additional things. Now, you can duplicate it. You can copy a link to the task if you're sharing it with somebody else, and this is something that's important. You can also add comments via email. So if there's any specific email trail that you want to bring in, you can BCC this, and you'll get a dedicated email address that you can basically bring in, which is fantastic. You can also see the task activity. Now, if you have multiple people working on this task, you can see everything that is happening as part of your account, which is incredibly helpful. You can also print this as well, and printing views is a great way to be able to see stuff if you're somebody that's much more of a visual person and you want to annotate your Todoist account. There's also a new ability where you can open this in a new window. Now, if anything you have in your account requires habitual revisiting, then you can use something called Track Habit. Now, Track Habit is great for meditation, morning routine, whatever it might be, but Track Habit turns this into a habit. And I think I want to explore that a little bit later because that's quite a helpful feature. There's also an additional ability called AI Assistant. I believe this is part of the premium plan, which helps to turn your tasks more actionable. Write article is pretty actionable, but if you're someone struggling with a title or you want to make it more specific, then it can use AI, ChatGPT probably, to regenerate the article. And in this case, you can rewrite it to detailed article. I don't really want to do that. And you can also turn the task to be broken down as well. So that's a little bit about each task. And obviously each task is quite helpful when you're using it. So I want to zoom back out and go to projects and how they live inside of your account. So this right here is called your inbox. Now you can actually organize your inbox in three different ways: a list, a calendar, and a board. I've got it in board view, but let's just bring it back to list view because it's the most default, easiest way to go. And an inbox is essentially anything you're just going to bring in. It could be a link, it could be whatever you want. You can even organize it in sections if you need that breakdown of where things are going to be captured. But these are tasks that don't have any due dates, they don't have anything. They're just here, they exist. And you can start adding more details to them, allowing you to process them for later at all the stuff we did earlier. And you can click into them at any given time and see the details, even adding them straight away to your account tomorrow, whatever it may be, to quickly add them and associate them. You can even drag them into certain projects if you need to as well, but do make sure, because you need to add due dates to them to help find them for later. Now, if you're somebody that organizes based on when something was added or a label that was added, you can use custom fields here to see things that are in your inbox for later, which is quite helpful. And you can break it down based on those filters too, which is really good as a feature. And as I said, you can even organize by board if you were to use sections. Sections could be, you could add a section for links, you could add a section for ideas, and be able to have that as your inbox area. And for some people, it's a great way to be able to break them down. You can move and archive these anytime. Calendar view is less specific because these are almost like things that you need to, you could use this as a triage area, if that makes sense. So in this case, I could say task ABC, and obviously it wouldn't go into there because it's not associated to a day, but you can go to do no date here and triage them to organize them into your calendar. I'm skipping ahead here. The calendar ability is good, but if you were using the inbox, you could use a feature like this to save you a bit of time. So that's just FYI, something that could be quite helpful. So now you want to set this up to the right setting. You can even set it to calendar to the whatever setting you find suitable. But here we go. I've started what I want as a layout, and I can move stuff between certain things here. If I move it to, why is it not doing that? It's not being my friend. Maybe there's a bug on the account. So I'm going to go to today. The today is the next best area for you. And this is where you're going to see your tasks, what you need to do for the day. And you can see what tasks have been completed. And what I'm just going to do is I'm just going to turn this into light mode for you, because I think sometimes it's quite heavy on the eyes. So we're going to go to theme, and we're going to go to Todoist. There we go. It's running a little bit slow because I'm uploading something in the background. But you can see the today area, and you can see what's been completed today and how long a task is going to take. And that's because I've time blocked. Something we'll come to in a moment. But this is a helpful activity that you can do to basically give yourself a duration for the day and how long you've assigned it to. So today is an area where you're going to see tasks that have a due date of today. If they have a deadline of next week, you're not going to see them. But you can organize this through list. You can do a few different attributes to it. For example, what project it's part of, what assignee it's sorted by. And you can even organize it based on that, based on the grouping, based on board, which is quite helpful. And you can see a calendar for today. Now, the benefit with the calendar is you can time block and see stuff. You can stretch stuff out. You can see what's planned. You can even break it down on priority level. And I can add a bit more attribution to this to give it a bit more color. So as you can see, if I were to drag on there, I can automatically plan. And it gives you an indication of where you are in the day. So the calendar is incredibly useful for that in terms of the day view. This is much more, can be customized. So in this case, I could add another task like write book and put it as a P1 for today. And you can see that they break them down per priority level. But if you view that as a board view, it's quite nice because you can be able to add more tasks to a certain priority level, or you can move stuff by project and you can see that these are inbox only ones. You can really narrow it down to the sorting and how they appear in terms of like how they appear on top of each other or the priority level, even if they're in a part of a different group, which is quite helpful. You can even filter by labels if you have premium, and you can filter by, okay, I only want to see P1 tasks in my today area because I need to focus on what's important. So this is a great way to really narrow down things. And the other thing that you can see here is anything that's all day in today is put up here. And the reason it's put up here is because you can drag it up from here or from down here, which means you can organize it for the day. So a lot of people like to do that because they don't want to give there's like sort of like a holding area for you, for your tasks. And that could be a great way to plan and coordinate your time. And you can see up here, this has been updated now to 2:45. So that's something that's incredibly helpful as a user. Now this, in my opinion, is probably the most powerful area of the areas of inbox today and upcoming. And the main reason I say that is because the week view, you can struggle between week or month view, but the week view is an incredibly useful view. And I like it because you can plan, but you can also see that week and it's not too intense. It gives you an idea of what's coming up. And now with deadlines, you can actually go to the task that was the task origin, which is quite helpful. Now, if I was planning my week and I was like, presumptually, I want to put task B, B, C, D there, I can move this around. I can move it down to my time blocking area and it will appear in all day here as well, which is helpful. So you've got a constant way to move stuff around, a constant way to see deadlines, a constant way to click into tasks, and a constant way to be able to move stuff and make it bigger. So obviously you can right click still onto stuff, and up here you can still move and see a week view, and you can toggle through the weeks as well. But this is quite helpful because you can Kanbanize it to week plan as well. So there is a smart default one, which you can set up a sorting, and you can even do all the priority and labels specific stuff as well, which is helpful. For some people, you may even want to use labels like this, like I'm only in a coffee shop and I want to see all the things I can do in a coffee shop that's associated with tomorrow, so that you can just zoom in on what's important. And then on the list view, it's actually a lot more attractive now because I can just free scroll, which is a great way to start planning ahead without the stress of skipping ahead and pressing buttons. You could just go, oh, February 8th, I can start doing that. And everything comes up here, which is really nice. So the calendar view, very, very helpful. You can also see future occurrences on. This is helpful for habits. So here's a great segue. Let's create a habit for lunchtime. And let's just say that habit is meditation. And I'm going to put that in my personal area. And I'm going to put it as P3. Now I'm going to click into the task and we're going to go down here, and it's down here, isn't it? And track habit. Now what this is going to do is override information in the task description because it's going to give us a streak ability, which will allow that data to appear in the streak. So as you can see, the current streak is 1 day. I'm going to take this off because maybe I've just done it. Maybe I've just meditated with you, but I'm going to press the future occurrences on. Now, what happened? It disappeared. That's because I was very silly and I didn't write every single day at 2 p.m. So what I'm going to have to do is untick it. So make sure your task is every day at 1 p.m. in order to get it there. And bang, boom, I've got all my daily streaks in here, which is absolutely perfect. So if I were to tick this off for tomorrow, then what's going to update in this here should update. It should update. There we go. To a 1 day streak. So you can see your habits within your account, which is really nice. And these are all future occurrences, which is cool. So you can start to see stuff that's helpful. Now, why is that helpful? Well, you can start plugging in your lunchtime. You can start plugging in your workouts. And that could be a good way to just zoom out and see everything, which a lot of people will find helpful. But some people might not like that. Some people like that time blocking. Some people don't. So you can always switch this off as part of future occurrences. You could even have it where a label is blocking personal, and then suddenly you have them all switched on if you did want to. So I'm just going to remove it for this case. Now, any deadlines you do have will appear inside of your account. So if I were to add a secondary deadline for Friday, you can see that they do both appear. Now, deadlines cannot be dragged into your account. That's just because they're deadlines. There's nothing you can do about that. But what you can do is be able to see them in this little preview, which is, again, incredibly helpful. So I think that's everything in terms of the inbox today and upcoming area. They're the biggest elements of your Todoist account as you get started. But it's really powerful in terms of what it can set up, which is helpful. Now, I would say there's nothing in projects that you can't do in those three areas, but they are more powerful with custom filters, and maybe something I'll explore in a more advanced session. But before we round everything off, I wanted to show you a few different things that you can do in settings to tune your account a bit more. Now, obviously, I've got a premium account, but you can still do a lot of this inside of the basic account. And you can choose where you see your home area. And that could be your upcoming, your personal, your reflection. It's your choice, which is great. And it's the one that opens up when you start your account up. You can also change your format, and as well as turning off that natural language that we recommended at start, you can do that manually through the due date. And finally, there are other abilities like whether you want task completion, resetting subtasks as well on things like that, as well as experimental features and keyboard shortcuts for quickly adding tasks. So just try and play around with that. There's also a ability to see things in your sidebar, like browse templates and things like that. And I actually didn't know I had that on there, but I'll get rid of it because there's no value in me having it down in the bottom corner. So I just think that these three areas are a great starting point in Todoist, and hopefully this gave you a warm introduction to it. And hopefully I helped you understand a little bit further and how you can use it. Now, in the advanced session, maybe we'll cover a little bit more about the projects and other abilities. So stay tuned for that, and I look forward to helping you there. Cheerio for now.